A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for Saturday, 20th July, on the front page you have Karnataka trust vote on Monday. So the governor's second direction was also ignored. Speaker adjourned the assembly. There was no trust vote held, and now the Karnataka trust vote would be held on Monday. So the governor of Karnataka had asked the chief minister to hold the trust vote on Friday, but that did not take place. Then below you have 3 killed in Bihar over buffalo theft. So police has detained 2 for interrogation too on this case. And this is Supreme Court questions need for NRC sample re-verification. So central government and Assam government, we had seen how they had submitted that the 31st July deadline needs to be extended and they want a sample re-verification. 20% sample re-verification to be done for borders districts of Assam, and for other districts 10% sample re-verification. So now this has been questioned, what is the need for this as such by the Supreme Court, because the entire NRC, National Register of Citizens, which has been updated in Assam, the NRC exercises Supreme Court monitored, and Supreme Court has set this deadline for the final NRC on updated NRC for July 31. Then on page 8 you have Brindavan of Vyasaraja Tirth rebuilt in Karnataka. So this was in news how this is a site near Hampi where desecration has taken place. Suspected treasure hunters had destroyed the site, and now the Vyasaraja Tirth has been rebuilt. On page 9 you have women in CRPF will soon get specially designed bodyguard. So this was an idea first mooted in 2016, and they have been using gear designed for men for so long, but now they would get specially designed gear, body gear. And this is Tamil Nadu government opposes Next for MBBS students. So the Tamil Nadu state governments have opposed this provision in the draft National Medical Commission bill, which proposes a common final year MBBS exam known as Next, National Exist Test, which will be for admission to postgraduate medical courses. So earlier we had seen how Tamil Nadu had opposed NEET as such too, for undergraduate, an exam for undergraduates for entrance into medical courses. And next is the exam for admission to, will be used as an exam for post-graduation medical courses too. And this has also been opposed by state government of Tamil Nadu. Then next is, plea to frame guidelines on identifying minorities. So Supreme Court has asked Attorney General to be served copy of advocate's writ petition. So a writ petition has been filed in the Supreme Court by Advocate Ashwini Upadhyay, which is seeking directions to the government to either frame guidelines for identification of minorities at the state level, or alternatively to declare Hindus as minority in states where they are a real minority. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is inclusion over exclusion. So this is regarding fears of a vocal section should not override the rights of NRC claimants to due process. So this is regarding the NRC exercise here. The deadline is of 31st July, and now complexities are further growing. Both central government and state government have sought extension, which we saw even today on the front page news. So this is inclusion and over exclusion. So means inclusion should be considered, rather that more can be included, but now what is being seen is a sample re-verification is being sought, that those who have already been included, whether they should be included or not. So that is the point. And this is unpresidential slant. So this is regarding US President Donald Trump's racist tweets, which have been reprimanded by the US House of Representatives too. For the first time in 100 years, a president has been reprimanded. So it was a non-binding resolution passed in the House. So this editorial says that Trump's racist tweets risk damaging the fabric of American society further. Then the lead article is the NEP and liberal arts education. So this is regarding the draft national education plan. It says the draft's endorsement of critical thinking would have gained credibility if it had promoted liberal values. So this is a critique on this draft national education policy. Next article is green shoots of economic growth. So it says without factoring in agriculture, the vision of $5 trillion economy will remain a distant dream. So this is something which had been announced in the economic survey that India has a vision to become a $5 trillion economy by 2024. So that is dependent on agriculture, and without factoring in agriculture, this would not be a dream coming true. So that is what this article covers. Then on Saturdays on the op-ed page, you have a ground zero coverage. So this is ecstasy and the agony. So this is regarding the small town in Kerala, which is emerging as a hub of narcotic trade. So trafficking and use is being seen here. So this is a coverage on this, the how to curb the problem, how the drug is easily available and accessible, which is spurring the trade. That is covered here. Then on page 12, you have bills to help transgenders, depositors introduced. So bills which have been proposed now have been introduced, like the transgender persons bill. And another bill which is mentioned here is this bill on depositors. So that is, you can see, banning of unregulated deposit schemes bill 2019, which specifically targets Ponzi schemes. But cheat funds would also be affected. So these bills have been introduced in the House, in the Lok Sabha. Then below you have Lok Sabha clears bill on NHRC constitution. So the Lok Sabha panel, Lok Sabha has passed this Protection of Human Rights Amendment Bill 2019 by voice vote. So this is a bill under which National Human Rights Commission has been formed. So the bill expedites the process of appointment of chairperson and members of NHRC and provides for, among others, including chairperson of National Commission for Backward Classes and National Commission for Protection of Human Child Rights, and also for persons with disabilities as members of NHRC. So OBC, SC, ST, National Commission members were already members, ex officio members of NHRC. Now further National Commission members have been added. So these reforms have also, amendments have also been called piecemeal and cosmetic by Congress leader Shashi Tharoor. On page 13, you have RTI bill introduced amid opposition flak. So center is to set service terms of panel, and this has been opposed earlier to right to information amendment bill, but the bill has been introduced in the Lok Sabha, and you can see it has been supported, though the opposition calls this as RTI elimination bill. So it has made various changes. It seeks to change the status of information commissioners who are on par with election commissioners. So it's, their independence would be affected, their salaries, allowances, other terms of conditions will be as prescribed by central government. So that would significantly affect the independence and their function. So this is the bill which has been introduced now. On international page, you have Israel spyware firm can hack data from social media. So this is a report in which it has been told that user data can be scooped from servers of Apple, Google and Facebook by this spyware firm. And this is Tehran dismisses US claims of destroying Iranian drones. So this is for the escalation of tensions in the West Asia between USA and Iran. And this is DA files complaint in US court against art dealer for trafficking antiques. So this is a prominent case. Mr. Subhash Kapoor from India, he is considered to be one of the main accused in allegation of antique trafficking. So he is in US and a complaint has been filed in US court, you can see. So there were artifacts worth 988 crores from India, Pakistan, Afghanistan, Nepal and other countries which were smuggled by him and seven others. On business page, you have Center rejects SEBI plea on transfer of reserves. So this is a bill Securities and Exchange Board of India has opposed, in which 75% surplus is meant for center is what the finance bill of 2019, which has been passed by Lok Sabha, says that SEBI must set up a reserve fund into which 25% of its surplus is to be transferred. The remaining amount is to be transferred to the central government. So SEBI objected to it, but center has rejected this objection. Then there's no news coverage on the last page. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website, asr.com. Thank you.